In this video, we're going to have a look at separating crude oil through fractional distillation. We're going to look at the properties of the different fractions and the uses. So crude oil is a mixture that has been formed from dead sea creatures over millions of years. It's a non-renewable fuel and it has lots of different uses, some of which we're going to look at today. So it needs to be separated into the different sections or fractions. How this is done, it is vaporised and heated really hot to a high temperature and pumped into the fractional distillation tower. Depending on the boiling point of the different sections or fractions, it will condense. At the bottom, we have the residue. This is used as bitumen. Now, bitumen is used for road surfaces. As we move up the fractional distillation tower, we have shorter chains of hydrocarbons. So the shorter the chain of the hydrocarbon, the nearer the top of the tower it condenses, whereas we'll have gases at the top which actually don't condense at all. They will still remain at room temperature as a gas. So if we have a look at the different uses of the different fractions, bitumen, as we said, is used for road surfaces, a long chain hydrocarbon. Fuel oil, this is used for ships. Diesel oil is used for cars, vans and lorries. We have kerosene. Kerosene's use is for aircraft fuel. Naphtha. Naphtha is used in cleaning products and chemical production. Petrol is we use for cars and vans. And at the top we have gases such as methane. Now methane has domestic uses such as heating and cooking. So if you turn on your cooker or your fire at home, methane is what comes out of the top. Now, methane is a short chain hydrocarbon. That means that it has one carbon and four hydrogens around it. At the bottom here, bitumen is a much longer chain of hydrocarbon. And because of that, that tells us a little bit about its properties. Because it's such a long chain hydrocarbon, you have to give it more energy for it to react, to start to break down. If, for example, I held a lighter to a road surface, nothing would happen. However, the gas taps in the science lab, if I were to turn those on and let the room fill with methane and I lit a lighter, it would go, it would blow very easily. A small amount of energy would be required because it's a shorter chain. There's no intermolecular forces acting upon it. So the longer the chain, the stronger the intermolecular forces. The harder it is, the more energy is needed to get them to break apart. So it's less volatile. And that's the key word there, volatility. Methane is highly volatile, and here we have bitumen, which is not very volatile. These are key points that we need to be aware of.